Welcome to IT Free Training's video on Group Policy Processing Order. In any large organization, it is more than likely that you will have multiple group policies affecting both computers and users in the domain. This video will help you understand which group policy settings are applied when multiple group policies are used within your organization. When multiple group policies are associated with the same computer, the following order is followed. First, local group policy that is configured for that computer is applied. After this, any group policies that have been applied at the site level are applied. The next group policy to be applied is at the domain level, while the final group policies to be applied will be organizational units. If there are multiple levels of organizational units, the group policy is applied starting with the top of the tree, moving downwards. Let us go through an example to understand how this works. In this example, the local group policy has been configured to apply custom desktop wallpaper and remove the recycle bin from the desktop. Since no other group policy has been configured in the domain, these two group policy settings configured in the local group policy will be applied. If a group policy is added at the site level to configure a proxy server, this will then be added to the result. The two settings from local group policy will still apply though, as the setting added from the site level group policy does not overlap with the settings applied from the local group policy. It is rare for group policy to be applied at the site level, though when it is applied, it will often be used for site-specific items like configuring proxy servers. If a domain group policy is added that sets the wallpaper while also disabling the control panel, what will then happen is the following. The wallpaper that was applied by the local group policy will then be overwritten by the group policy settings that were applied at the domain level. Disabling the control panel has also been added to the result. The proxy server configured at the site level still remains, as does removing the recycle bin from the local group policy. In this network, some computers have been configured to test out new software and thus require the control panel. In order to do this, another group policy is created and applied to a testing OU. Since the group policy enables the control panel, notice in the results the control panel has been enabled again. You can start to see how powerful group policy is. At each stage, settings are either added or replaced to the resulting group policy settings. This allows you to customize group policy to meet the needs of your organization. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to look at how to configure group policy. First of all, I want to configure local group policy. In order to do this, run Edit Group Policy from the Start menu. In this case, the setting that I want to configure is the desktop wallpaper. This group policy setting can be found under Administrative Templates, Desktop, and Desktop. Under Desktop, select the settings Desktop Wallpaper. Once I enable this group policy setting, I will configure it to use an image store on a file server. For the wallpaper style, I will configure it to stretch to ensure the wallpaper always fits the resolution the user is using. Once configured, I will then exit out and configure the option to hide the recycle bin. This setting can be found under Administrative Templates, Desktop. The setting that I'm after is Remove Recycle Bin from Desktop. To configure this group policy setting, all I will then need to do is enable it. Once enabled, I will now close Group Policy Management, log off, and then log back in again. Since I have only changed user settings, the group policy settings that I have changed will be applied when I log back in. There is no need to reboot. Once logged back in, notice that the wallpaper has changed to Configured from Local Group Policy. Also notice that the recycle bin is no longer visible. Even though you can configure settings using local group policy, in most cases it is not recommended due to there being no centralized control, thus making them difficult to manage. To configure group policy in the domain, I will now run Group Policy Management from the Start menu. In this case, I will configure group policy at the site level. Before I can assign group policy at the site level, I first need to create a group policy object. I can do this by right-clicking Group Policy Objects and then selecting New. I will call the group policy New York Proxy Server, since this group policy will be used to configure the proxy server at the New York site. Some of you may be thinking, could I have created a group policy on the New York OU rather than at the site level? When you organize your Active Directory objects like this, it is possible to configure a proxy server at the OU level and achieve the same result. You can see that even though it is possible to configure group policy at the site level, many administrators will use different methods to get the same results rather than use site-level group policy. Once the group policy is configured, the next step is to go down to Sites, right-click it, and then select the option Show Sites. Once I select which sites I want to show, in this case the site New York, the next step is to right-click on New York, then select the option Link an existing GPO. Now I will be able to select the group policy object that I created earlier. Unlike when assigning group policy to organizational units, there is no way to create and link the group policy in one step. Since sites are configured at the forest level, this feature is most likely not available, since when creating the group policy, it could be created in any domain in the forest. By not having the option, this forces the administrator to create the group policy object in the correct domain, rather than group policy management guessing which domain the group policy object was to be created in. Once configured, I can right-click the link to New York Proxy Server and edit the group policy object. Most settings any administrator will configure are found in administrative templates. In this case, the proxy settings are found under Windows Settings, Internet Explorer Maintenance, and then Connection. To configure the proxy setting, all I need to do is select the option on the right, Proxy Settings. Once I enable the setting, I can then enter in the address of the proxy server. Now that the proxy setting is configured, I will next configure the settings at the domain level. I will first modify the group policy, domain-wide group policy. This is a group policy that I created in an earlier video. To configure the desktop, I will once again go down to Administrative Templates, Desktop, and down again to Desktop. The setting that I'm after is Desktop Wallpaper. If you have watched our previous videos on group policy, you may remember that I have already configured this setting. Before I start this demonstration, I will clear this particular group policy setting. Otherwise, configuring the local group policy desktop setting will have no effect. Once enabled, I will then configure this setting to use special desktop wallpaper that I created with the writing on it indicating it came from domain group policy. Like the local group policy setting, I will also configure it to stretch so that the wallpaper fills the screen if the user uses a different resolution. I will now exit out of here and configure the group policy setting to disable the control panel. This can be found under Administrative Templates and then Control Panel. The setting that I need to configure is Prohibit Access to the Control Panel. This setting only needs to be enabled. When enabling settings such as these, take the time to read the description. Since the setting disables the control panel, it needs to be enabled. If this setting was configured to disabled, this would enable the control panel. Once configured, I will exit out of Group Policy Management, then log off and log back in again. Once the user logs back in again, Group Policy will be reapplied for that user. Notice that the wallpaper has changed to the wallpaper specified in the domain group policy. This group policy setting has replaced the group policy setting that was configured in the local group policy. Notice also the recycle bin is still hidden. as this setting was configured in the local group policy setting. If I open the Start menu, notice that the control panel has been hidden so the user cannot access it. In some cases, you may have a user that needs different settings than the other users. In this example, this user is testing some software and needs access to the control panel. To achieve this, I will create a special OU for this user. To do this, open Active Directory Users and Computers from the Start menu. Expanding downwards, you can see that the User Trainer is under New York, Users, and then Marketing OU. For this user, I will create an organizational unit under Users by right-clicking on Users, selecting New, and then Organizational Unit. I will now call the new organizational unit Testing. Once created, the next step is to move the Trainer user account into the Testing OU. Notice that when I move the user, I get a warning telling me that moving objects around the domain can affect the user, for example, which group policy settings are applied to them. Since this is what I want, I will press OK and then exit out of Active Directory Users and Computers. To create the group policy object for the Testing Organizational Unit, run Group Policy Management. I will expand down to the Testing OU, right-click and select the option Create a GPO in this domain, and link it here. For the name of the group policy, I will call it New York Testing. Once the group policy is created, I can edit it. To enable the control panel for this user, I will expand down through Administrative Templates, Control Panel. From the right-hand side, I will select the option Prohibit Access to the Control Panel. See how this setting is configured to Not Configured? This means that it will not have an effect. In order to reverse the effect of disabling the control panel configured in the Domain Group Policy, I need to select the option Disabled. This will effectively enable the control panel. The wording may seem a little strange at first. Once configured, I will then exit out of Group Policy Management and once again log out and log back in again. A point to note here, if the computer account was moved in Active Directory, the computer will need to be restarted in order for Group Policy to be correctly applied. Since it is only the user account being moved, I can log out and back in and get the correct group policy settings. Notice that the wallpaper is still being applied at the domain level and the recycle bin has been removed from the desktop. If I go back to the Start menu, notice the control panel has reappeared in the menu. In this video, I have looked at the order group policy is applied. This is local, site domain, and then OUs. It is important to understand this order when troubleshooting group policy in your domain. Some of you may have already worked out that if you configure a group policy at the domain level, this will affect all computers and users in the domain. This includes domain controllers and administrators. Disabling the control panel for the domain administrator was probably not the result originally intended when configuring the group policy at the domain level. This is just one example of why you should be careful when configuring group policy, as a wrong setting can affect all the users and computers in your domain. In the next video, I will look at how to target group policy a bit better to avoid problems such as unintentionally removing the control panel from all your domain administrators. As always, thanks for watching another one of our always free videos from IT Free Training. See you next time.